Hello, my dearest students and my dearest friend. Today we are going to speak about prescription, Latin part of the prescription. We have been already studying the pharmaceutical terminology, and everything that we have already studied, we will need it for writing out the prescription. At first, prescription is a list of so-called commands which the doctor gives to the chemist to perform such kind of medication and to administer it to the patient. As for the Latin part of the prescription, because traditionally it consists of a lot of parts, the exact picture of the prescription you can find out in our theoretical material. Today we are going to speak just briefly about the Latin prescription part. As you can see from my blackboard, that is the list of the commands, and if you have already understood, it's the list of the commands in the imperative mood. For example, take, mix, give, designate. These are the parts of so-called Latin part of the prescription. The first one will be recipe. The word recipe will be in imperative mood, and it is the order like take. Then we put double points, and after double points we are writing the medical medication in genitive case. It means that, as you have already known, almost all medications will be in neuter gender. That's why That's why in genitive case we are changing ending into e ending. If this is medication in genitive case, in genitive singular, then we add the dosage form. If it is 1 milligram, then we are writing it like this: 1.0, without any milligram notions. If it is 10, for example, we are writing it like 10.0. If it is the liquid form of the medication, we are writing it with denoting that this is milliliters of such kind of the medication. If we have show that these are the drops of something, we are supposed to write like this. If it is 1 drop, we are writing gutam and 1 Roman number. If there are 2, 3, 4, 5 or more drops, we are writing like gutas, and then denote how many drops you are supposed to take of these drugs. And besides, if you have the enumeration of the drugs forms, we are writing, and they are in the equal dosage form, we are writing the enumerations of the drugs, and then ana, and then we are writing the dosage form. Next one. This is the easiest one, I think. If we are supposed to determine and to show in our prescription that this is the ready-made medication, for example, where the doctor is writing out the tablets or suppositories or lamellas or spangias, right? We have to remember that these forms will be in accusativus pluralis, and for you to remember that they will be tabuletas, suppositoria for suppositories, lamellas, lamellas ophthalmicus for lamellas, and spongias for spongias. And the name of the drug after this will be in genitive case. If we have the exact name of the drug in leps, so after leps, the name of the drug will be in nominative singular. This is the first part. The second part, we have to write what we have to do with the drugs which are given. The first one, the easiest one, this is mix, is to mix like misce. If there are there is a number of some drugs, we are supposed to show that to which form of the drug we are supposed to do it. For example, misce, fiat, and then the medical form will be in nominative case. I mean, it is pulvis or unguentum or something like that. Yeah? If after word fiant we have plural, nominative plural, then we are writing fiant. Once again, the singular form, misce, fiat, plus nominative singular. If it is the plural form, it will be misce, fiant, plus plural form of the nouns. Then we are supposed to finish our, this is, will be da or give, it is in English. And the last one, this is designate. This is the last portion, designate, which is translated like signa. This is the last portion of the Latin prescription, which is written in Latin language. After signa, we can write in your native language. Either this is Russian, if you're going to write out the prescription in Russia, or your native Indian or something like that.